attention for all the chicks in Kent. It was a bright and beautiful morning, late in May, and his corns were so much better that he resolved to walk through Hickley Brow to his farm. It was 3 miles and a half altogether, through the park and villages, and then along the green glades of the Hickley Brow preserves. The trees were all dusted with the green spangles of a high spring, the hedges were full of stitchwort and campion, and the woods of blue hyacinths and purple orchid, and everywhere there was a great noise of birds, thrushes, blackbirds, robins, finches, and many more, and in one warm corner of the park some bracken was unrolling, and there was a leaping and rushing of fallow deer. These things brought back to Mr. Bensington his early and forgotten delight in life. Before him the promise of his discovery grew bright and joyful, and it seemed to him that indeed he must have come upon the happiest day in his life. And when in the sunlit run by the sandy bank, under the shadow of the pine trees, he saw the chicks that had eaten the food he had mixed for them, gigantic and gawky, bigger already than many a hen that is married and settles and still growing, still in their first soft yellow plumage, just faintly marked with brown along the back, he knew indeed that his happiest day had come. At Mr. Skinner's urgency he went into the runs, but after he had been pecked through the cracks in his shoes once or twice, he got out again, and watched these monsters through the wire netting. He peered close to the netting, and followed their movements as though he had never seen a chick before in his life. "What they'll be when they're grown up, it's impossible to think," said Mr. Skinner. "Big as a horse," said Mr. Bensington. "Pretty near," said Mr. Skinner. "Several people could dine off a wing," said Mr. Bensington. "They cut up into joints like butcher's meat." "They won't go on growing at this pace, though," said Mr. Skinner. "No," said Mr. Bensington. "No," said Mr. Skinner. "I know this thought. They begin rank, but they don't go on, bless you, no." There was a pause. "It's management," said Mr. Skinner modestly. Mr. Bensington turned his glasses on him suddenly. "We got 'em almost as big as the other place," said Mr. Skinner, with his better eye piously uplifted and letting himself go a little. "Me and the missus.